Hi everyone, I hope you all are safe and doing well. You can see that I have this sad and very unhealthy looking rubber plant. Now this was the same rubber plant that I had branched a couple of months, I think a year ago, and it branched out successfully. But I think the plant is suffering from some sort of disease, and so I decided to do, I tried saving it and using a clean, a very sterilized pair of knife, I cut the plant into two. So just take any knife, or if you have a pruning tool, that's amazing. So I took a clean knife, I sterilized it using some hydrogen peroxide, and I cut the plant into half. Now sterilizing is extremely important, otherwise we can cause some sort of infection to the plant. So I transplanted the mother plant into a clean potting mix. I used some fresh garden soil mixed with some cocoa peat, and I planted the mother plant into a smaller pot because this is a time of shock and the plant needs to adapt. The plant will do a lot of work, will invest a lot of energy in branching out and in producing new nodes so that it can sustain and thrive. So the rubber part, it's gonna dry up, and a scab is gonna be formed. You can see that this was after around some 12 days that the plant produced two new nodes. Now the first node is bigger because the plant is investing a lot of energy in producing new leaf. So I think one of the nodes is dormant, because maybe not dormant, but it is smaller in size. But the bigger node is of course growing very fast, and it's developing at a very fast rate. So all this while I kept the plant into a shaded area where it received a lot of bright but indirect light, and I kept the soil moist for the initial days. Now the bigger node, the top node, it started opening up, it started unfurling pretty quickly, and within a few days we had a brand new, a very delicate and a beautiful looking leaf. Here you can see that the leaf opened up. Now once I noticed that the plant has produced a leaf, I made sure that I was not over watering the plant. I only watered it when I noticed that the top soil was absolutely dried out, because over watering can cause serious damage. It's often known that we kill plants due to over watering as compared to under watering, so please be mindful that do not over water your plants. The second node is taking its own sweet time. It is as it is, it is not growing, but I'm leaving it as it is. I do not want to interfere and let the plant take its natural course. Things are looking healthy. I think the second leaf is also almost ready to unfurl in a couple of days. So after a week or so, the second leaf also opened up, and the plant is looking very healthy and beautiful. This transformation has been of course life-saving for the plant. So sometimes I think we do have to take this risk. I am someone who doesn't like pruning too much or unnecessarily, just for the sake of making videos or experimenting. I only do when it's absolutely necessary, because I personally do not enjoy cutting down stems when they are not required. But sometimes when they are necessary, we do have to take these measures. Now this was the footage that I shot today, and you can see that the leaf is getting bigger and the plant is looking absolutely healthy, whereas the node is as it is, it's not growing. I am hopeful that it will grow one day. So I hope if you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And until next time, stay safe and happy gardening.